Hi, Kuya Christian here, and today let's talk about your dreams and goals in life. We are now on the second half of 2020. Kamusta ang mga pangarap mo? Kamusta yung mga bagay na gusto mong gawin dapat ngayong taon na to? Lahat naman tayo may goal, di ba? We all have dreams, we all have aspirations. But 2020 has given us a big obstacle to overcome in order for us to reach our goals and dreams and aspirations. This pandemic has even caused some of us to lose hope. Feeling natin hindi na natin matutupad yung mga pangarap natin. Tama ba? Yung iba sa atin sumuko na. Yung iba sa atin, we just want to quit because we think that this is going nowhere, that our dreams will never come to pass. But today, I am glad that you are here with me because I want to encourage you through the life of Joseph in the Bible. Joseph, like us, had a dream, and that dream came from God, and that surely will come to pass. But he also had a lot of hurdles in order for his dream to come true. The first obstacle was the hatred of his brothers towards him. At first, they wanted to kill him. Pero nagbago ang isip nila at binenta na lang siya. And so he ended up being a servant to Potiphar. And the Lord blessed everything that he was doing. But then another obstacle came. He was tempted and seduced by Potiphar's wife. Alam mo yun, yung feeling mo bumabalik na ulit yung pag-asa, pero dahil sa isang scenario, bumagsak ulit ang lahat. Yes, Joseph was seduced and tempted, but he ran away. He never compromised. Yun ang una nating tatandaan as we have these goals and dreams in our lives. Never, ever compromise. Do not step on other people or do not go ahead of God just to fulfill your dreams and aspirations. Instead, never compromise and trust God's plan for your life. The second thing that I want you to remember through the life of Joseph is trust God's timing. Nakulong si Joseph, and in that prison, nakasama niya yung cupbearer ng king at yung baker ng king. Ngayon, itong cupbearer na to nagkaroon ng panaginip at sinabi ni Joseph as he interpreted his dream na after 3 days, babalik siya kay Pharaoh. So Joseph wanted to somehow pabilisin yung proseso ng paglabas niya sa prison. Na sinabi niya doon sa cupbearer na sana kapag ka bumalik na siya doon kay Pharaoh, sabihin niya na palayain siya doon sa prison. But you know what? God's timing is always perfect. Naalala lang nung cupbearer si Joseph after 2 long years. But the timing was so perfect because the Pharaoh had a dream. And then the cupbearer remembered that he also had a dream that come to pass. And the interpretation was right. The cupbearer remembered Joseph. And so Joseph went to the Pharaoh and then he interpreted his dream na magkakaroon ng famine at kailangan na itong paghandaan. And because of that interpretation, si Joseph binigyan ng kapangyarihan over Egypt at nag-ipon ng Egypt. And then the dream of Joseph came to pass. And lastly, everything happens for a reason. You see, yung mga obstacles na dinaanan ni Joseph, lahat pala yun parte ng plano ng Panginoon sa buhay niya. And perhaps this big obstacle that we are going through right now is part of God's wonderful plan for our lives. So hang on to your dreams. Hang on to your goals in life. Yes, we have a big pandemic that is somewhat a big obstacle to reach our goals and dreams that the Lord has given us. But have hope in God. And remember, never compromise. Trust God's timing, and everything happens for a reason. God bless you. When my soul is weakening, when my strength is still I believe.
Wait on you, God. I'll be strong and will take heart. I'll wait on you, God. Oh, still.
Father, I pray for the one who's watching this right now. I pray that as they wait upon your wonderful plan for their lives, give them patience and endurance as things unfold. Keep them safe, O God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.